Hi students, and welcome back to bankexamstudy.com. And this is the additional video in our 60-day basic to advanced English course, because when we started this course, the students were weak in English. So we tried to improve their grammar, and along with that, the students who have applied for SBI Clerk, RBI Grade B and some other exams, and they want the videos on reading comprehension, para jumbles and other English topics. So that is why we are doing this video. This reading comprehension passage has been sent by a student of our 60-day basic to advanced English course. He wanted me to do this, and I am doing this for everyone out there who is preparing for SBI Clerk or RBI Grade B. And if you are facing problems in reading comprehension, this video is going to help you a lot. So let's start by reading the passage. But here, first I want you to read the questions. Before we start reading the passage, I want you to read the questions. So when we start reading the passage, we can find out which line can be the answer of our questions. Otherwise, there is no point of reading the complete passage and just keep on finding the answers for each question. So that is why we are going to start with reading the questions. The first question is, the area most prone to salinization are. So salinization is the excess of salt in the soil. So we have various options here. Those irrigated with well water, those in which crop rotation is not practiced, subtropical forests, flat land irrigated from reservoirs. So we have four options, and now we have to find the answer from the passage, right? And then the second question is, the most appropriate title to this passage is Problem of Soil Erosion, Agriculture in Volcanic Islands, The Importance of Chemical Fertilizers, Cause of and Remedies of Soil Infertility. Then the third question is, natural fertility exhausts most quickly in, and we have options, river valleys, humid tropical forest, volcanic areas and land near urban areas. The question number four, the factor that can restore fertility to the soil not mentioned in the passage is. So we have various factors that can be helpful in restoring the fertility of the soil in the passage, and we have to find out which is not mentioned in the passage. Clear? So we have to find the not mentioned one. Crop rotation helps in increasing the farmer's seasonal income, preserve soil condition, desalinize the soil and destroy pests. And the sixth question is, one of the characteristics of agriculture land in Nile Basin is. So we have to find the feature of agriculture land in Nile Basin. And then the last question is, the plant with nodules on their roots are known as. We have four options, debris, leafy vegetables, legumes, grain crop, and E is none of the above. So let me tell you what are nodules. Nodules are these small swelled parts of the roots, and we get grains from these parts. We don't get grains, we get the legumes. Legumes are like beans. So we get beans from the nodules of the plant roots, right? So here the answer is very clear, it is C. We get grain crop. Grain is obtained from the upper portion of the crops, and debris means the waste. Leafy vegetables are the leaves that we eat, and so we are left with the option C, which is the correct answer for 7. So this was not in the passage when I found it on the internet, but the student who sent me this added this question maybe. So I'm just explaining what are nodules and what are the meanings of these words. And now, after reading the questions, we are going to read the passage. I have read bold and red words or sentences that will help us to find the answers quickly. In your exam, you cannot bold or underline or highlight the words, right? But what can you do is you can just memorize their place. Where did you find that line? And how is it connected to your question? That is why I asked you to read the question first, because when you know the question, you can find the answers in every line you read. So let's start. A conservation problem equally as important as that of soil erosion is the loss of soil fertility. First, we have the meaning of soil erosion, that is the loss of soil fertility. So we know that the chapter is based on soil erosion, right? Most agriculture was originally supported by the natural fertility of the soil. We know that agriculture is entirely based on how fertile the soil is, right? And in areas in which soils were deep and rich in minerals, farming could be carried on for many years. It says that the areas where the soil has minerals and rich nutrients, there farmers have been farming from many years without the return of any nutrients. It means that farmers are using the soil, but they are not doing anything to return the nutrients of the soil. They are just using the nutrients, but they are not doing anything to return that to the soil. Other than those supplied to the natural breakdown of plants and animals, animal waste. It means farmers are not doing anything, but if there is a natural breakdown or the animal waste is in the soil, that supplies the nutrients and of the soil in river basins such as that of Nile. Annual flooding deposited a rich layer of silt over the soil. So we have Nile, in which the layer of silt is submitted or deposited over the soil, thus restoring its fertility. It means the areas near Nile are fertile because every year when there is a flood, they deposit a layer of silt over the soil, and thus the soil gets its fertility back. In areas of active volcanism, where the volcanoes are very active, such as Hawaii, soil fertility has been renewed by the periodic deposition of volcanic ashes. It means areas there where we have volcanoes that are active. So what do they do? The ashes from the volcano helps us to renew the soil fertility. In other words, however, natural fertility has been quickly exhausted. It means we are overusing the natural fertility of the soil. This is true most forest soil, particularly those in humid tropics. It means the fertility that we are overusing is mostly seen in the forests that are located in humid tropics. Clear? Because continued cropping in such areas caused a rapid decline in fertility and therefore in crop yield. It means we are just using the area to crop for the cropping, and that is why the crop yield is declining and fertility is declining, because we are overusing the soil. We are not doing anything to get back to its fertility. So what can we do to restore the fertility? Fertility could be restored only by abandoning the areas and allowing the natural forest vegetations to return. It means once you have a cropping in the soil, you just have to leave the soil abandoned, blank. Do not grow anything on that soil, and allowing the natural forest vegetation to return, so that when you don't crop or when you don't sow anything in the soil, the natural vegetation will grow and that will return the natural nutrients of the soil. Over a period of time, The soil surface would be rejuvenated by parent materials. New circulation channels would form deep in soil, and the deposition of forest debris would restore the minerals to the topsoils. Now we have the solutions how we can restore the soil's fertility. When we will leave the soil abandoned, there will be parent materials and there will be natural vegetation. There will be forest debris. Debris means the wastage. The forest waste material would help to restore the minerals in the topsoil. Primitive agriculture in such forest was of shifting nature. Primitive means of ancient ages. In ancient times, what we used to do is we were shifting the crops. Areas were cleared of trees and woody material burned to ash to the soil. After few years of farming, the plots would be abandoned and new sites cleared. It means we used to shift the cropping on the soil. Once a crop is cut down, we burn the ashes to the soil, and that ashes are used to rejuvenate the soil. As long as population were sparse in relation to the areas of forest land, such agriculture methods did little harm. It means sparse means very rare and scarce. When population is not very thick in some areas, agriculture can be less harmful to the soil, because we do not use the soil that much. We don't overuse the soil, but when the population is increasing, we have to grow more products to eat. We need more production of agriculture goods. So we just start overusing the soil. That is very harmful. They could not, however, support dense population or produce large quantity of surplus food, because the soil cannot support the large quantity of surplus food because its production capacity is very limited. Starting with the most easily depleted soils, which were also the easiest to farm, the practice of using various fertilizers was developed. It means that we found a soil which could be easiest to farm, and to get more production from the soil, we developed fertilizers. The earliest fertilizers were organic manure, right? So when we were not that much advanced in scientific ways, we did not have the scientific manures, though the fertilizers were organic, they were natural. But later, larger yields were obtained by adding balanced combination of those nutrients. So what we did, we started getting more and more production, larger yields, by adding balanced combination of those nutrients. It means we started adding the chemical fertilizers like potassium, nitrogen, phosphorus and calcium that grow plants require in great quantity. So for our selfish motives, we did harm to the soil, we did harm to the nature. Because high yields are essential, most modern agriculture depends upon the continued addition of chemical fertilizers to the soil. So we need more production, we need higher yields, and that is why modern agriculture is entirely dependent upon the continued additions of chemical fertilizers. What we do to get more production, we add chemical fertilizers. Usually these substances are added in mineral forms, but nitrogen is often added as urea, an organic compound. Earlier in agriculture history, it was found that the practice of growing the same crop every year after year in particular plot of ground not only caused undesirable changes in the physical structure of the soil, but also drained the soil of its nutrients. So what we wanted to say here, that when we were in the primitive ages, we used to grow the same crop in the same land, and that is why the physical structure of the soil changed and the nutrients were drained. Nutrients were Newtons were not present in the quantity that was required for the crop to grow. The practice of crop rotation was discovered. That is why what we did, we discovered the practice of crop rotation, which maintained the condition of the soil. And it also helped to prevent the buildup of those insects and other plant pests that are attracted to a particular kind of crop. So how did soil rotation help? Soil rotation maintained the condition of the soil and it prevent the building up of insects and pests. Clear? In rotation system, a grain crop is often grown first year, allowed by leafy vegetable in the second year, and the pasture crop in the third. So this is the circular motion of the crop rotation. First we grow the grain crop, then we grow the leafy vegetables, then we grow the pasture crop, so that the nutrients in the soil are balanced. The last usually contains legumes, because such plants can restore the last means pasture crop. So here legumes is also called pasture crop, because such plants can restore nitrogen to the soil through the action of bacteria that live in the nodules on their roots. So legumes have nodules on their roots. We found the answer of the last question. Then in irrigation agriculture, in which water is brought in to supply the needs of crop in the areas with insufficient rainfall. So when the rainfall is not very effective and insufficient, what we do, we started irrigation. So from where do we get the irrigation water? It is from the reservoirs, canals, it is from the rivers, right? A particular soil management, so what did irrigation lead to? It led to the soil management problem that develops in the salinization of the surface soil. So irrigation led to salinization. Why did this happen? This most common result from inadequate drainage of irrigated land, because the land does not have the proper drainage system. That is why water cannot flow freely and it evaporates. When water is just standing without having any drainage system, it started evaporating and the salt in the water is left on the soil. Clear? Even though the water does not contain a large concentration of dissolved salt, the accumulation over the years can be significant enough to make the soil unsuitable for crop production. It means that maybe we are not using the irrigation water that much and the quantity of salt in the irrigation is very less. But when we are using the same water for over a period of 5 to 6 years, then the dissolved salt is high, right? So that can be harmful for the soil and the soil production and the crop production. So how can we get rid of the salinization? We need an effective drainage system that can be helpful in many problems, like drainage canals must be constructed, drainage tiles must be laid beneath and the surface of the soil. Drainage also requires the availability of an excess of water to flush the salt from the surface soil. So drainage will help us to flush out the excess of salt that is present on the surface soil. In certain heavy soils with poor drainage, this problem can be quite severe, where the drainage system is not very effective, and maybe there is no drainage system, it can be severe. The salinization problem can be severe, and example of this are Indus Basin, Tigris-Euphrates region, Nile Basin, and in the Western United States. where the soil is seriously damaged by solanization. So we have completed the passage. Now we are going to attempt the questions. The areas most prone to salinization are those irrigated with well water, those in which crop rotation is not practiced. This is not the one. Subtropical forests, flat land irrigated from reservoirs. Flat land means there is no drainage system and the water comes from the reservoirs. So that is the main reason of solanization in the soil. So D is the answer. Most appropriate title to this passage. Problem of soil erosion? No. Agriculture in volcanic islands? No. The importance of chemical fertilizers? No. It is the causes and remedies of soil infertility. We found the reasons of soil infertility and we found the remedies. So this is the answer. Natural fertility exhausts most quickly in where does the natural fertility exhaust most quickly? River valley, humid tropical forest, volcanic areas and lands near urban areas. It cannot be river valley lands. It cannot be volcanic areas. It cannot be lands near urban areas because we did not read anything about this. So we are left with option B, which is the correct answer. So in the very first paragraph of the passage, we read about this. So we have here we have natural fertility has been most quickly exhausted. This is true of the forest soil, particularly in the humid tropics. Clear? Then the fourth question says the factor that can restore fertility of the soil not mentioned in the passage. Alluvium brought by the rivers, we read about this, about the Nile River. Bacterial action, we read about this. Organic manure, we read about this also. But we did not read about the fertilizer fixing through lightning. So C is the factor that is not mentioned. It is the correct answer. Others are already mentioned in the passage. Now, how does crop rotation helps? It helps in the increase of farmer seasonal income? No, we did not read about this. It preserves soil's condition. We did read about this. Desalinize the soil? No. It destroys the pests. It is correct. So second and fourth is the correct answer. Answer C. Then question number 6. One of the characteristics of agricultural land in Nile Basin is... It contains a lot of bacteria? No. It consists of heavy soil with poor drainage system. The Nile water contains excess of salt and it contains nutrient minerals. So what did we read about the Nile basin? Let us have a quick. It has problem of salinization. Right, it has poor drainage system, so it can be Nile water. We did not read about Nile water, so it cannot be the C. It contains nutritive minerals. It is correct, but we do not use it. So, it consists of heavy soil with poor drainage properties. This is the correct answer because we have read about the Nile system. Here we have drainage system problem. It was about the soil of Nile, not about the water of Nile. So, it can be a poor drainage system and the consist of heavy soil because it just keep on accumulating after the floods. So, the soil is very heavy. So answer B is correct. We have already done the seventh question, that is nodules and legumes. So we have done the reading comprehension. I hope you understood this. And if you have any queries, you can email your queries on this email ID. And this video is the part of our 60-day basic to advanced English course. So if you want any query or any questions regarding this course, you can call on this number 906-720-1000. So you can call on this number and get the answers of your queries about our 60-day advanced English course. So we will meet in the next lecture. Have a nice day and thank you for watching this video.